Dear children, today I am going to tell you some questions of the chapter Motion and Measurement of Distances. So, my first question is, what are the three modes of transport? The three modes of transport are landways, waterways and airways. Give two examples of all the three modes of transport. Land transport, car and bus. Water transport, ship and boats. Air transport, aeroplanes and helicopters. In ancient times, how early man moved from one place to another? By walking. After that, what had happened? After that, he made a cavity in a log and traveled from one place to another through rivers. Who discovered steam engine? James Watt in 1786 discovered steam engine. Who discovered aeroplanes? Wright brothers discovered aeroplanes. Now, next question is, mention the two contributions in 20th century towards transportation. The two contributions in 20th century towards transportation is electric trains and supersonic aeroplanes. Mention some modes of transportation of ancient times. In ancient times, there were some modes of transportation like bullock cart, horse cart, camel cart, etc. Now, mention the name of universally accepted system of measurement. System of international units or SI units is a universally accepted system of measurement. Explain how did people know how far they have traveled in ancient times. By measuring distance by a particular standard unit of measurement, we can measure how far they have traveled. Now, what is motion? When a body changes its position according to its surroundings with respect to time is called motion. For example, a moving car on a straight road. Now, when a body is said to be at rest, when a body does not change its position with respect to time and its surrounding, it is said to be at rest. For example, a stationary car or a car at rest. Now, my next question is, can an object be in motion and rest simultaneously for different observers? Give an example and consequences. Yes, a person driving a car is in rest with respect to other person in car, but in motion with respect to a person standing roadside. State of motion and rest depends upon observer or reference point. Now my next question is, we need a standard unit of measurement for a quantity. Explain why. We need standard unit of measurements because the unit like hand span, foot, cubit differ from person to person or even in different countries. So far a uniform measurement, standard unit of measurement is really required. Now we will discuss the next questions in next video.